Hello everyone, welcome to Talent Battle. In this video, we will look at one previously asked coding question in Goldman Sachs test. Name of the coding question is subsets of zeros. Problem statement is, Ashutosh is a very mischievous student. His mathematics teacher wants to teach him a lesson. So he gave Ashutosh an array of positive integers ARR with elements in array as A1, A2 up to AN, where each AI is greater than 0. After that, prime sum is an integer which is equal to sum of all the prime factors of each element in ARR modulus 10 raised to 6. Ashutosh's job is to find number of ways in which a set of prime sum number of zeros can be divided into k subsets modulus 10 raised to 9 plus 7. Ashutosh is a little nervous. Can you help him get out of this trouble? A note is given that a subset can be empty. After this, input format is given. The first line indicates the number of subsets k. Then the next line has a single integer n denoting length of array. And next, n lines contain the integers in the array. Input format for custom testing is also given. 2 is the number of subsets that is k. After that, the next number will be length of the array, that is n. After that, next number is again for length of the array for HackerRank representation of integer array. And next n numbers which will follow are nothing but the elements of array. After this, output format is given. An integer representing the number of ways in which a set of prime sum number of zeros can be divided into k subsets mod 10 raised to 9 plus 7. Constraints for the problem are, each element of array, that is AI, that will lie between 0 to 10 raised to 6. After that, value of n, that is the number of elements in array, that will range from 1 to 10 raised to 5. And value of k, that is the number of subsets, that will range between 1 to 100. Alright, after that, sample example is given. Now, I know this problem is a bit difficult or complicated to understand. So, understanding this sample example is very crucial. So, we know the very first number in input is for k, that is the number of subsets that we have to make. After that, next number n stands for the number of elements in our array. So, this value is for n, and this 3 is repeated, that is nothing but for the HackerRank representation of elements of array. Okay, and this 1, 2, 6 are the elements of array. Okay, so the very first thing we have to find out is the value of prime sum. That prime sum is an integer whose sum is equal to sum of all the prime factors of each element in ARR. Okay, now if in this case our ARR array is 1, 2, 6. So now we have to find out the sum of prime factors of all these numbers. Now there are no prime factors for 1, we know, so it is blank. For 2, prime factor will be 2, and for 6, prime factors are 2 and 3. If we make sum of all this, that will become 2 plus 2 plus 3, and that is nothing but 7. Okay, so prime sum in this particular case is 7. Now, what we have to find out is number of ways in which a set of prime sum number of zeros can be divided into k subsets. Okay, so prime sum number of zeros, so that is in this case, say 7 zeros. And we have to divide this set into k subsets. The value of k in this particular case is 2. Okay, so we have to divide this set in 2 subsets. And in how many ways we can do that, that is the answer we have to find out. And since that answer can be very large, we have to do it mod 10 raised to 9 plus 7 just to avoid the integer overflow. Okay, so as it turns out, in explanation it is given that a set of 7 zeros can be divided into 2 subsets in 8 different ways. Suppose first subset is empty and second subsets contain all the 7 zeros. After that, suppose first subset contains only 1 zero and second subset contains 6 zeros and so on and so forth. So in the similar way, there are 8 different ways we can divide this. And obviously our answer in this case will be 8 modulus 10 raised to 9 plus 7, and that is nothing but 8 itself. So that is why the output for this particular case is 8. Now next input given is our value of k in this case is 3. number of elements in our array are 3 again, and elements in array are same as previous case, that is 1 to 6. So we know that the prime sum for this particular arrays is 7. So now we have to find out that in how many ways we can divide a set of 7 zeros in 3 subsets now, because value of k for this example is 3. Okay, there are total 36 ways in which we can divide a set of 7 zeros in 3 different subsets. So that is why the output for this particular example is 36. So let us turn our attention now in finding out what can be the approach to solve this particular problem. So this problem can be divided into two parts. First problem is finding out the sum of all prime divisors of each element of the array. And second part is in how many ways a set of prime sum number of zeros can be divided into k subsets. Alright, so for first part, algorithm we can use is sieve of Eratosthenes. We can modify this algorithm a little bit to find sum of all prime divisors for all elements of array. And let me just explain the logic for finding out all these prime divisors up to 10 raised to 6 in a small scale. Suppose we have numbers only up to 15. So now in this case, we know that there are no prime divisors for 1. So we will just strike it off. After that, next number is 2. We know that 2 itself is a prime number. So 2 has one prime divisor as 2 itself. And we will just add this 2 as prime divisor for each multiple of 2 in all our remaining numbers. So in 4 as well as in 6, 8, 10, 12 and 14. In all these cases, we are going to add 2 as the prime divisor for that particular number. Alright, and after that, next number is 3. Now we again know that 3 is our prime number. So we are going to add 3 as a prime divisor for 3 itself. And all the remaining multiples of 3 in remaining elements, we will add 3 there also. So in this particular case, that is 6, we will add 3 as prime divisor. For 9 also, we will add 3 as prime divisor. For 12 also, we will add 3 as prime divisor. And for 15, we will add 3 as a prime divisor. After that, next number is 4. Now 4 is already striked off in our iterations. So that is why 4 is not a prime number, so we will not count for 4. So next number is 5, which is not struck off already. So we know that 5 is prime number. So we will add 5 as a prime divisor to itself. So I will write down 5 here, and all the remaining multiples of 5, that is for 10, we will add 5 as a prime divisor. And for 15, we will add 5 as a prime divisor. And so on and so forth. I have taken this example only up to 15 for the sake of explaining, in such a way that we have to carry forward these numbers up to 10 raised to 6, because the constraint, the maximum number in our array will be up to 10 raised to 6. So we will do this thing for up to 10 raised to 6, and after completing the iteration, we are going to get the sum of prime divisors for all the numbers. So in this particular case, we know for 2, sum of all its prime divisors, it's 2. For 3, sum of all its prime divisors is 3. And look at this 6 now. For 6, sum of all its prime divisors is 2 plus 3. That is 5 again. Alright, so in this particular way, we are going to find sum of all prime divisors for all elements of array. Let us talk about time complexity for this particular approach. So when we will add 2 to the sum of all prime divisors in all the multiples of 2, in that case we would have to make a total n by 2 iterations. Similarly, when we will add 3 to all its multiples, it will become n by 3 iterations. Similarly, for the next prime number, that is 5, we would have to make n by 5 iterations, and so on and so forth. Alright, so if you see all the numbers in denominators here are prime numbers. We can prove with the help of harmonic progression that the time complexity would be big O of n log of log n.
Alright, I am not going into the mathematical explanation of this particular complexity.
After finding out this prime sum value, now our next part is finding the number of ways in which a set of prime sum number of zeros can be divided into k subsets. Alright, so let me just call this sum of all prime divisors, that is prime sum, as p now. Okay, so the ways in which we can divide a set of p zeros into k subsets is given by p plus k minus 1 factorial upon p factorial multiplied by k minus 1 factorial. Okay, so this is the formula which we are going to use to find out the number of ways to divide this particular set of p zeros. Now let us put the values of this example in this formula. So for this example, we know value of k is 2, and we know the value of sum of all prime divisors of all numbers in this case, that is p, is 7. We have already calculated that using modification of sieve of Eratosthenes. Okay, so if we put these values, this will become 8 factorial upon 7 factorial, and 8 factorial upon 7 factorial is nothing but 8 itself. Okay, so that is why this 8 is our answer. We have output as 8. Obviously, we have to do a mod of 10 raised to 9 plus 7 to this particular value. But in this case, this mod won't affect final answer. So 8 will be our final answer. Let us take this next example, this below example here, and in this case we know the value of k in this case is 3, and value of p we already know, it is 7. So if we put these values in our formula, now this value becomes 8 into 9 upon 2, and finally this is nothing but 4 into 9, that is 36. Alright, so 36 would be our answer, and indeed our output for this case is given as 36. This is the code for this question. First of all, we are taking input for all the values. First of these inputs is k, that is number of subsets. After that, we are taking for size of array, and after that we are just taking input for all the array elements in this particular loop. The name of our array is arr and its size is n. So after this, the main logic part starts. In this sum of prime divisors array, we are going to store the sum of all prime divisors of all the numbers up to 10 raised to 6. Alright, so that is why the size of this array is 10 raised to 6 plus 1. Why we are taking this size as 10 raised to 6? Because it is given in the problem statement itself that no number in our array ARR will exceed 10 raised to 6. Okay, so every particular position in this sum of prime divisors array will have the value of sum of prime divisors of that particular number. For example, the sixth position in our sum of prime divisors array will have the value of its 2 plus 3, which is equal to 5. In the similar way, the 21st position in our sum of prime divisors array will have sum of prime divisors of 21. Now we know prime divisors of 21 are 7 and 3. So the value at 21st position in our sum of prime divisors array will be 7 plus 3, that is 10. Okay, so to fill up this sum of prime divisors array, we are going to use that sieve of Eratosthenes algorithm. So in this outer loop, we are iterating from 2 to up to 10 raised to 6. And whenever sum of prime divisors of I is encountered as 0, that means that particular number is a prime number. So we are going to add this prime number to all its multiples in their sum of prime divisors value. So that is why in this inner loop, we are iterating from j is equal to I up to j is less than or equal to 10 raised to 6. And j is equal to j plus I. So that is nothing but we will only iterate through the multiples of I, and we are adding this I value, that is this particular prime number, to the sum of prime divisors of j. Okay, so whatever will be this sum, we are just doing it modulo m, where m is initialized to 10 raised to 6. It is already given in the problem statement that this sum of prime divisors should be modulo 10 raised to 6 to avoid the integer overflows. So that is why doing this modulo m at every intermediate step is also important to avoid integer overflows in intermediate steps also. Okay, so once we complete iterations of this loop, we will have our sum of prime divisors array ready for all the numbers from 1 to 10 raised to 6. But now, of course, we do not want the sum of all the prime divisors of all the numbers up to 10 raised to 6. We only want value for the numbers which are present in our ARR array. Okay, so that is why in this below loop, we are going to iterate through all the numbers which are present in ARR of I array only, and whatever will be the value for sum of prime divisors of those numbers, that is this thing, sum of prime divisors ARR of I, we are going to add those values to our total sum variable. So that is why we are doing total sum is equal to total sum plus sum of prime divisors of ARR of I. And we are doing again modulo m to this thing to avoid the integer overflows. And after this, whatever will be the value of total sum, I am just printing it down here. And I am just assigning this total sum value to this variable p. And after that, I am doing all the further calculations in this next function. And I am passing these values, that is total sum and k, to this particular function. Alright, so we already know the formula to calculate the number of ways in which we can divide this set of p zeros into k subsets. P plus k minus 1 factorial upon p factorial into k minus 1 factorial. Now we know that while calculating this particular value, that is p plus k minus 1 factorial, we can reduce our number of calculations either by cancelling out first p terms or cancelling out first k minus 1 terms from the overall product, because this p and k minus 1 factorial are anyways also present in the denominator also. So generally, as the value of p is going to be greater than value of k, I am going to cancel out the product of first p terms from the numerator value, and we will also cancel out this p factorial from the denominator. Okay, so this numerator will only remain as p plus 1 into p plus 2 and so on and so forth up to p plus k minus 1. Okay, so we are reducing this whole factorial into product of these terms only. I am taking one numerator variable which is initialized to p plus k minus 1. After that, in this for loop, I am just calculating this value, that is p plus 1 into p plus 2 up to p plus k minus 1, that is this numerator. And whatever the product of this whole equation, I am storing that in a fact variable which was initialized to 1. So fact is equal to fact multiplied by I, and we are taking this modulo 10 raised to 9 plus 7 at every intermediate step. Now after calculating this value for the numerator in the below loop, we are calculating the value for denominator. Now if you notice, we have already cancelled out this p factorial from the denominator. So only thing present in denominator now is this k minus 1 factorial. So it is quite easy. I have taken one variable, that is k fact, which was initialized to 1. Then in this loop, I'm just calculating this k fact in the simplest way possible, that is k fact is equal to k fact multiplied by I, and I'm taking modulo 10 raised to 9 plus 7 at every intermediate step. And once we know both these values, that is fact, which is the value at our numerator, and this k fact, which is the value at our denominator, we are just dividing that. That is answer is equal to fact divided by k fact, and I am finally just returning that answer to the called function. Okay, so this answer will get received here in our main function, and whatever is this answer, we are going to print that as our final answer.